Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Andrew Brankley and welcome to this video, Using Stable 2007 with CSEM Only Evaluees. The content of this video is based on our meta-analysis that was published in the journal Sexual Abuse. A link to the article can be found below in the description section of this video. This video will not be a summary of the entire article. For that, please refer to my two videos titled Does Stable 2007 Work? Available now on my YouTube channel. This video focuses on a section of the discussion in which we talk about the application of Stable 2007 with CSEM only cases. Given that this seems to be such a small part of the paper, why have a separate video on the issue? Sadly, the answer to that is that CSEM-only cases are on the rise. You only have to turn on your TV to hear about them.
A Vancouver teacher has been implicated in a child pornography ring.
Child pornography.
In child porn.
Child pornography.
Hi, I'm Jared the Subway Guy.
You are probably familiar with a number of different names for this problem. In laws and in everyday conversation, the term child pornography is used. This term is falling out of favor, in part because of the use of the word pornography to describe what is necessarily sexual abuse. Unlike adults, children are not capable of consenting to sexual acts, and so a term like child sexual abuse images has been used. Because content can include things other than images, for example, sexualized stories about children, people have started to use child sexual abuse materials. And lastly, exploitation is starting to replace the use of abuse to describe a wider range of harm to children. Men who engage in CSEM offenses are different than those who engage in other types of sexual offenses. These findings are summarized in a 2015 meta-analysis by Dr. Kelly Babchishan and colleagues. They aggregated studies that compared men who committed contact offenses only, CSEM offenses only, and those who committed a combination of both contact and CSEM offenses. On outcomes associated with general criminality, example, antisociality, impulsivity, men with CSEM-only crimes were consistently lower than the other two groups. This finding was almost flipped when looking at sexual criminality, which includes things like the paraphilias and hypersexuality. Men with contact-only offenses had the lowest scores. Individuals with CSEM-only offenses were sometimes lower than the mixed group on some variables. These results are one of the reasons why current recommendations are against the use of existing risk tools with CSEM-only clients. This poses a significant problem for those conducting risk assessments, as very few tools have been tested in this subpopulation. The Child Pornography Offender Risk Tool, or CPORT, was developed by Drs. Michael Cito and Angela Eek to address the limitations of other tools with this subpopulation. CPORT is similar to Static99R in measuring risk because it makes use of commonly available information. For CSEM-only cases, no criminal history is available. This limits information about clients' risk factors, as 3 out of the 7 items are based on questions about prior criminal history. Measures like Stable 2007 may be particularly important for assessing CSEM-only cases because they use other sources of information. In our meta-analysis on Stable 2007, we had 12 unique samples, one of which had a significant number of cases with CSEM offenses. This sample was from a 2007 paper by Webb and colleagues published in Sexual Abuse. The study came from the Challenge Project, a community treatment program located in Southeast London.
London calling to the faraway towns,
72 participants in their sample had a CSEM offense. 68 only had a CSEM offense. We analyzed the stable's ability to predict sexual recidivism in this sample using the area under the curve statistic. The result was a significant value of 0.94, a large effect. In other words, there's about a 94% chance that a recidivist would obtain a higher score on Stable 2007 than a non-recidivist. Both recidivists in this sample had new CSEM offenses. Besides the Webb and colleagues sample, four other samples had CSEM participants that contributed to the significant effects we found overall. We didn't analyze them separately because we were either unable to identify them within the dataset or their sample sizes were too small for separate analyses. Overall, we concluded in the paper that these results provided initial evidence for using Stable 2007 in assessment with CSEM-only participants. But remember, this is still only the first steps in testing the validity of Stable 2007 in this subpopulation. We don't want to get ahead of ourselves.
Oh, I get it. Don't be hasty.
Exactly.
Barum.
Those silly hobbits. Always doing impressions of my deep voice and my affinity for smoking pipe tobacco. but I hope my point was clear. In this video, I simply provided a theoretical argument that Stable 2007 would be a reasonable measure of risk-relevant propensities amongst CSEM-only clients, and then reviewed some of our initial evidence from our meta-analysis. Please feel free to share this video for training or teaching purposes. I'm happy for you to use the video or slides themselves in your own presentation. I just ask that you leave the slide intact and reference it accordingly. Also, feel free to contact me if you have any questions or comments. If you liked this video, then I hope you check out my other videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel.